I'm a fire chief with 25 years of experience. During my time as a first responder, I've responded to a number of workplace accidents. One of the things that I notice is that employers don't always know what is required of them, what they should do, how to care for the victim, and who to notify. So this video is intended to help you, as an employer or a manager, better manage critical incidents in your workplace.
So you need to get medical attention to that person immediately. If you need to call 911, you can do that. Get them. They're the most important thing.
If a critical injury has occurred in your workplace, the first thing you need to do is make sure that your rescuers are safe, that it's safe to enter the area where the accident has occurred. Then you need to focus on the victim, find out what the injuries are, determine whether they need further assistance, medical assistance, and then call the appropriate resources, whether it be an ambulance, paramedics, fire service, whatever is required to get them the care that they need and look after the patient.
You always make sure that you have somebody go with them, and the best person to go is the supervisor because they have the information, and it's also important that the family knows what has happened to the individual. The next thing is just secure your accident scene. You just secure it. You just basically have somebody stand there. You're not allowed to touch anything. Don't move anything, because you're going to have to do an investigation later down the road, and you need to secure that.
Once you've dealt with a medical emergency, what you need to do is see if there are any witnesses. Did anybody see what happened? You need to prepare for an investigation. What caused the accident, and how can you prevent any accidents in the future? So any serious injuries should be reported to the Ministry of Labour. All injuries need to be reported through the WSIB reporting system.
You need to know that if someone falls and breaks their leg, or it's very obvious they broke their leg, that is a critical injury under the Occupational Health and Safety Act. It's defined. So you need to know what to do. There's a whole set of procedures, there's a whole set of things that need to happen. So you need to have a policy in place based on that definition, and also responsibilities with everybody in place, so everybody knows what to do. What happens in a critical injury is people are worried about certain things, and they don't necessarily know what to do. And I think that's one of the things that we find with critical injuries, is that people aren't really, they're worried about the person, which is your most important thing to do, but they can do things that can implement and actually impact them later down the road, such as disturbing the accident scene or doing something that they're really not supposed to under the Occupational Health and Safety Acts.
An employer should have a plan and should communicate that plan to their staff and to their management. They need to understand what to do if something happens in the workplace, who's going to call for help, who's going to perform first aid, who's going to provide the necessary resources to make sure that the victim is looked after.
There's a whole set of procedures, there's a whole set of things that need to happen. So you need to have a policy in place based on that definition, and also responsibilities with everybody in place, so everybody knows what to do. And it always looks good on paper, but I really, really strongly recommend to people to practice it.
We dealt with one company where they practiced their fire drills, but what they didn't realize was, what's our secondary exit? And during the one fire drill, I stood at the bottom of the stairs of a main exit and said, "I'm a fire. Now what are you going to do?"